Can the analog sticks in a PS5 controller be repaired? Well, let's find out. You don't know until you know, and hopefully by the end of this, we'll know. I purchased this controller to confirm repairs and practice on. So, let's say the left analog stick is drifting. First, we start by plugging it in and loading up the testing software. Arm yourself with a plastic spudger, no metal pry tools here. Start by popping off the black trim to reveal the front screws. Now pop off the L1 and R1. Here are the rear screws. Once the screws are out, flip her over and observe the two clips. Here and here. And release them. Now gently but confidently pry the shell apart. For the edges, slide the spudger along the seam. Once you feel some resistance, give the spudger a little twist. Here I had a bit of a problem resisting the rear shell, but it came off okay anyway. Now the rear shell is off, we'll get rid of the battery. Then remove the screw here and take out the battery tray. Be mindful of the flex cable here. Take out the touchpad flex here. Remove the trigger cables. Remove the second flex cable right here. Next up is removing the rumble motors. With slight pressure from underneath on the analog sticks, remove the small clips, the PCB can now be liberated from the shell. So comparing the analog stick modules, the only real difference is the black side clip on the PS5 module, as you can see here. Other than that, there appears to be zero differences. Footprint looks the same, clicks, looks and smells like a duck. Pop off the speaker. I've mounted the PCB and used Captain Tape to protect the flex connectors. Captain Tape will stop direct heat from melting the connectors. I'm treating this like any other PCB repair. The hot air station used here is a quick DW861BA. Temperature is around 450°C and airflow at 85. I regulate the temperature by the height of the nozzle from the PCB. This method almost always guarantees no damaged pads and clean holes. Everyone likes a clean hole, eh? I've seen too many repairs from people just using soldering iron, solder wick and a sucker. These boards just wick away the heat from the soldering tip. As soon as you have to start prying out the module while holding the soldering iron on the underside of the PCB, you should really stop. Hot air is the way to go. Anyway, rant over. As the solder melts, the module will release. Now keeping the heat on, go around each hole with the sucker. Using 100% IPA and a Q-tip does wonders. Mounting the module correctly is the single most important step. Try to hold the PCB, apply pressure to the module to keep it square. Dry fit the module and observe at the bottom of the potentiometers, green things with the three pins. Make sure it's parallel to the PCB. Any tilt to the module will stop the stick going full travel. You'll get, say, 100% full travel left, but only 95 right. Again, doing some finger gymnastics here to hold the PCB and keep the module flat. and clamped to the board. Time to release the shmoo. So I soldered the four anchor points with a small amount of solder. This makes it easier to adjust the module if it's not level. Heating one anchor point while pushing the module into the board. This makes it a lot easier to readjust the module if there is any tilt. Carefully solder up all the joints. Once each joint has been soldered, don't be tempted to go over them several times. With decent solder and flux, this shouldn't be necessary. Solder it up and move on to the cleanup. This is the one I replaced. Remember the grey clip? The gap under the module should be level and even all the way around. This is really a good time to see if there are any issues. While it's out of the shelf, we can check it's working and centering correctly. In all honesty, not much to say here. I'll mention a few things as I go on, but there will probably be some text. I remembered to put the speaker back. I also remembered to put the rubber grommets back. I removed them just before heating up the board. Here I'm testing the stick goes full travel, 100% in all four directions. There's a small tab on the end of the mic which latches into the battery tray. If it's not in, the mic will not sit correctly. On goes the rear shell, starting from the trigger side. Once the rear by the triggers is seated, the front part just snaps down to close up the shell. Here we go again, same deal. Slot the end of the mic into the shell and make sure the flex cable is under the little hook. Face trim was a pain in the ass here. There. Now on to testing. Well, that's it. And now we know. For Xbox, PS4, PS5, SCUF, and custom controller repairs and spares, please visit us at www.ubermicro.co.uk. Book in your repair now. Thanks for watching. See ya.